the lecture to today. So this morning, instead of following the normal schedule, we will start with a half an hour presentation by Nixon, and then we will move on. So the first thing that we are going to start today is a presentation on CLP for NET. That's the IAEA's e-learning platform. How do you work? Most of you are familiar with this CLP for NET. You already done your pre-training and your pre-test for your qualification to this program. So, and then there are many more uses of this CLP for NET. So Nixon is my colleague working in NKM section. He has a lot of experience in this field. He would expose you to how you can better use this CLP for NET. Not only for this application, you can, after going back to your country, you can try to use this CLP for NET for many of your requirements. There are a lot of information available in CLP for NET. So how to access them, how to effectively use them. And this half an hour presentation is for that. And most importantly is this is going to help you to, next 2 weeks you need to access CLP for NET. Every day you need to access to see the presentations are loaded there and you can copy them or view them as you like. Also, the final exam will be on the CLP for NET platform. You have to have access, then only you will be able to do the final exam. So make yourself familiar. If you have any questions, please ask him. And he is going to be here for only one more day, tomorrow. Day after tomorrow, he will leave. If you have any questions, I may not be able to answer to you on CLP for NET. So I strongly recommend all of you to interact with him and learn if you are having any access issues, if you have difficulty in getting into CLP for NET before Nixon leaves. So Nixon, the floor is yours.
Good morning, dear colleagues. My name is Nixon Paul Pereyapadan, and you could call me Nixon. I am working in the International Atomic Energy Agency in the Nuclear Knowledge Management section under the Department of Nuclear Energy. Most of you have received many mails from me during the last few months requesting you to access this learning management system, CLP for NET, and to review the course pre-training course materials and to follow up on the final test, etc. The reason why I have sent you all these mails are because I am serving as the system administrator for IAEA's learning management system, CLP for NET. And today in my presentation, I would like to give you a brief outline about the rationale behind the e-learning activities in IAEA, why is CLP for NET, and what is CLP for NET, technology used in CLP for NET, and the current status, and what learners of this school could expect from CLP for NET after this school and during this school. And if time permits, I will also just make a walkthrough through the system so that you will be able to see some more functionalities of the system. So to begin with, as many of the lecturers told yesterday during their presentations, nuclear energy is now in limelight. What it means to the staff of the organization, because even though the nuclear energy is getting expanded, the staff and the resources in IAEA is not getting expanded. So I will tell you what is the rationale behind our learning management system. The more attention to the organization means it's more pressure for the staff to deliver things in less time and with existing staff. To cite an example, when we organized the first NEM school in Trieste in 2010, our intention was to organize only one school. That will be the core school in ICTP. But after 6 years, now on an average yearly basis, we are getting 8 to 10 requests from the member states to organize the same school in their countries or in some of the regions. This year, we had 8 requests and we could implement only 4. First school was in UAE, then we had one in Japan. This is the third one in Trieste, and fourth one will be next month in St. Petersburg. So we are getting more and more requests, it doesn't mean that our resources are getting expanded and we have to live with our limited resources and we have to develop and support the existing maintaining the all the training programs. Due to resource constraints, we also need to decrease the dependency on external experts because we can't accommodate or we don't have resources all the time to fund the external experts for the trainings. And also we need to avoid repeated material, course material creation. We found that if all the course material, for example, this school, most of the lectures are of continuing nature, the curriculum is fixed. So we feel that there is no sense into invest all the time resources to create something new. And moreover, it is also very difficult to get senior level or middle level managers for 1 whole week or 2 weeks in a classroom and to train them. This all made us to think, our management to think that we need to find out some innovative ways of giving trainings. And one solution what we found is that we need a platform or we need to create a lot more learning resources through e-trainings and etc. Now the situation is that all 6 IAEA departments are seriously considering about creating e-trainings or e-learning modules. This ended up in a situation that we have too much information, we have many e-learning modules and we have many e-trainings and other things. And all the departments are disseminating this information in different ways. Means some of them are putting it into their websites and some of them are distributing through USB sticks or even some of them are handing over during printing it out and handing over during the trainings. This made us to think that we need a consolidated approach and we need a place where to put all this information so that all others other than us, for example, if Department of Nuclear Energy is developing a training program, this will be some elements could be used by Department of Safeguards for their trainings. So we thought that we should need a consolidation and we need a place to store everything. And also the member states nowadays needs detailed statistics on the effectiveness of the trainings. And if we are putting through our websites or if we are distributing through the traditional ways, we don't have an opportunity to find out the statistics. Whenever they are asking, we can't provide how many users used it and how much learning time took for each courses and modules. And as a big organization, we also have the internal auditing. The auditors, as you know, always needs some return on their investment. They want some data. So that we thought that, okay, we will have a learning management system which is capable to deliver everything. The end result is that we have now the cyber learning platform for network education and training. And this is to build and support the capacity building activities and knowledge transfer. It's a web-based system. And we consider this as a cost-effective, scalable, and easy-to-use platform. The NKM section, which is managing this platform, is providing this as a service to IAEA staff and its limited cooperation partners. When we want to develop a system, we had the traditional way of having a consultancy meeting, and the consultants recommended that we should use the Moodle technology because it is widely used. It has got around 80 million user base, and it is in 100 languages, and moreover, it's an open source. So we need not to pay any license fee. It has got a forum to support, and I think some of you have already used it in your university because it is widely used in the universities. As the time grew, the user base grew, our IT department is now getting very serious about the IT security issues. So last year, we had some audit and they requested that we should move to the umbrella of Nucleus. Nucleus is the place where all the major IAEA databases and systems are put in one single place. So they asked us to incorporate it into Nucleus. So in Nucleus, if you go to the Nucleus, then you will see the fourth item. It is Disciple Learning Platform. This is one of the reasons that you can't go directly to the learning management system due to the security issues. You should go through the Nucleus. From Nucleus, it has got a single username and login ID. With that, you can also use all other systems. For example, Connect or Gavatom or everything. Whatever is here, you need to have only single username and password. And we are also part of, since last year, we are also part of the Nucleus. Now I will explain you the components in CLP4Net. It has got three major legs. One is the self-directed learning management system. Self-directed learning management system means you can, as a user, you can come in, you can use your own username and login, and you can enroll to the course. There is no tutor, there is no instructor behind all the time. This doesn't mean that you will not get any support. If you have any questions, you can communicate to the manager of the course, because the manager of the course will be visible at the beginning of each module. The other one is the protected learning management system. It is basically used only for the IAEA trainings. Or whatever you see here in the protected learning management system, you will not be able to access unless and until a scientific secretary or a PMO or some credible IAEA partner requests us, the CLP4Net administrative team, to grant the access. For this, you need some authentication or some verification. But we are planning that we may integrate in the future. In 1 or 2 years, all the courses will be open to the public with some limited access. But this is still under discussion. The third leg is the integrated database on nuclear education and training. We have many cooperation partners, network partners in different regions. We have already LANENT, maybe in Latin America, and ANENT in Asia. And we have ENEN in Europe. So we have so many networking partners. So our basic aim is to request the networking partners to gather the metadata of all the training programs in nuclear education and put it in one place. And it will be available through CLP4Net platform as this leg. This may take the platform, the technology is already taken care of, but the content, gathering the content, we are still negotiating with the counterparts. So it may take another 3-4 months to get it established. Now I will show you some user base of the system. When we started in September 2014, the instructor-led management system, we had around 1,700 users. And in the open system, we had only 140 users. But now we have 11,700 users in the self-directed. So it is the open learning management system. And we have around 7,100 or 7,200 users in the instructor-led management system. And the user base, the course base also increased considerably. We had, when we started operation, we had only 5 or 10 courses in, total 15 courses. But now we have around 600 courses. That means during the last 3-4 years, it grew considerably. As I mentioned to you, this is the open learning management system. You could use the URL elearning.iaea.org, then you will be able to see all the courses, 115 courses. You could self-enroll. These courses are in different categories. This I will be able to show you when I make a live demo. Then we are getting on an average 80,000 page reviews. And the protected learning management system, this is the URL. And this is basically to give pre-training. And also it supports the face-to-face training. And we also want to make a post-evaluation. There is an end-of-event surveys, and there is an assessment possible. And we are having around 400 training courses. And On an average, we have 50,000 page reviews. Now I will explain you what you could expect as a participant of this school, during this school, what you could expect from CLP4Net. We will make sure that all course materials are available immediately or within 2-3 hours delay. All the material will be there. And there will be also information about the group projects and assessments. And there will be a model exam, will be next, not this Wednesday, but the next Wednesday evening, there will be a model exam for you to just familiarize with the final exam. Then the final exam will be there. And moreover, this will be a place where you can open the communication channels. It means all the participants of the school will be registered and you can communicate among yourself because all the emails are there, the system is capable to send messages inside so that you will be able, if you want to communicate among yourself, this will be possible. And we have strong community, means all the last four, six years, participants are in the system. They are communicating, they are interacting each other, and they are also developing. So that this we are considering as a space for communication. And here you can also assess the lectures. This is very important for us to know the feedback. As I have seen yesterday, I was checking how many of you have made the assessment of the lectures. I found only one. So we encourage that all of you take some time to assess the lectures, because next year, and this year also, we are having this school in a continuous nature. And the lectures, moreover, the lectures are almost the same or with some minor adjustments. So if your feedback will help us to assess, because we will be able to know that whether you could follow the lectures and whether it is making it useful to you, etc. So we suggest that you also make an assessment of all the lectures, and we are taking serious note on it. And after this school, the course materials, because we have seen that all the course materials of the last year school is still accessed by the students of that school. So this will be there for at least 4 or 5 years. All these lectures and all this information will be stored in the platform. So you will be able to revisit this one. And also there will be some kind of survey. After 2-3 years, we may have a follow-up survey. This survey is to get to know that whether this course or this school helped you to advance your career. Because this will be very useful for us to see how you are learning from this school. And only 42 of you could make it to the course. But at the same time, if someone in your country is interested to access this course material, if you request us, if the request comes through you, then we will be able to give them also the access. And we are also negotiating with our senior management that we will be able to issue a course completion certificate. This is only a certification that the course is completed online. And this does not guarantee anything, but at the same time, they will be able to review the material and we will be able to certify that they participated online the course material. Now, what I will do is that I will make a short demo to the system so that we could make a walkthrough and I will be able to show you. So as I mentioned to you, these are the three legs. This is the self-directed learning management system. And we need a login. Now I am in Nucleus. So if you click on each category, here we have 5 categories. And these all courses are for the self-enrollment. As a user, you will be able to enroll. And if you just need to access the course, you just need to enter.
Hello and welcome. This EMA module provides an introduction to nuclear knowledge management, or NKM. My name is Gary Cairns, and I have been helping the IAEA for many years as an external consultant.
Okay, I won't spend much time. And at the end of the module, you will be asked to follow a short quiz. So this is a simple, some simple questions. And at the end, you will be, because it is still under development, at the end, you will be able to get a certificate. I will show you something else, somewhere else. This is what we could see. We could see that how many users enrolled. As I mentioned, for our auditing and for to find out that whether it is the usefulness of the course, we will be able to see how many students registered and how much time they spend. There are many courses in safeguards and security and nuclear security and safety. If you could see, there are quite a lot of number of courses. And all these courses you could enroll. Sorry, this is under development. All these courses you could be, you are, it is simple, you could just need to go and enroll, self-enroll. Now I will go to the protected system, where comes our school. This is the school which you are participating. There was some questions by some of your colleagues saying that the ICTP is also video recording. So what is the purpose that now we do it? The thing is that we are not video recording, we are taking only the video feed from ICTP. At the same time, we are packing it as a learning, as a course. For example, if you want to know more about Mr. Chudako, here is the profile of Mr. Chudako. And this is the presentation which he delivered yesterday. And if you want to listen to his presentation.
Stop developing conferences, big meetings, developing countries is thinking about the nuclear power. That we have now about 30 countries, they're thinking or.
So all the presentations and all the materials except Mr. Stefano Monti's presentation, everything is online. And this is the assessment which I was suggesting you to just answer. This is very simple and it is only 3 questions. And if you have some feedback, some comments, please feel free to write. Then we will be able to, our senior administration and the scientific secretary will be able to know more about the effectiveness and where we need to adjust. And later, during as the course progresses, everything will be added, all the course information will be there, and there will be also an end of event survey. These are the information about the group projects, because this is the first group, all this information is already uploaded. So, the final test will be open on the last day. There will be a model test. Model exam will be open. It will be visible on next Wednesday, not this Wednesday, but the Wednesday afterwards. And there is an end of event survey. And all the group information, like photographs and other things, also will be added here. But the access to this folder will be granted only after the end of event survey is completed. Because because we have a problem that we don't get much after the school, nobody is really bothered about to fill the data. So this will be provided only after the end of event survey is over. And maybe it is also interesting for you to see how we selected you. Because apart from the nomination process, we had some screening mechanism. This is the pre-training, which you all participated. And we have hidden an attendance. This shows that how much time you spend, how serious you were, how much time you spend. Because we had around 300 applicants, and we selected, shortlisted 87 to do the pre-training. And from some few countries, we had two equally good qualified candidates. We had two nominations, and we don't know whom we should take, and whom we should accept, and whom we should reject. So we applied the criteria who spent more time in the platform. As the time progresses, this will be applied in other program areas too. For example, we are working with the Technical Cooperation Department, because this is the pre-training which they want to do for all these events. Because in 2017, they have three major events, and all the students will be asked to go through the pre-training. It's a mandatory criteria. And they should send the certificate to the scientific secretary, the course completion certificate. This, as an administrator, I am getting it. Yeah? So once the QC is over, the course completion certificate is there. This you have to send to the PMO. Then only the funding, the fellowship, will be approved. The PMO also has a chance to see whether the participants, because it is still under development, there is also an attendance register to see whether the participant or the fellow has been serious and they took some time to go through the course material, etc. So this is in development. It will be implemented from 2018, second half year onwards. So what I strongly suggest to you is that to spend some time, because there are a lot of course materials and it is easy to use. If there is any issues, technical issues on accessibility and other things, please feel to communicate to us. Or if you need some guidance on the content, there are contact points for each course material. So just contact them, and we are there to help you out. Thank you.